Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. I'm gonna have a look at filament from 3D fuel called DOW Evolve3D OBC. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is was an interesting one. It's a new type of material and I've never seen this before, but let's have a look at the label. So here they say its name is DOW Evolve3D OBC and print temperature should be 175 to 210 and bed temperature 60 to 100 and speed 10 to 40. It's quite a flexible filament, so speed shouldn't be too high, but fan should be turned off. Here they say it will stick best to polypropylene tape or packaging tape. And here's the info, Evolve3D olefin block copolymer OBC print filament is a high performance 3D printing build material that prioritized sustainability across the product lifecycle. Made from a unique polyethylene based material. Sorry, I can't say those words. The Evolve3D OBC filament is a breakthrough material that brings polyolefin properties to 3D printing, very low density for light strong parts. So let's have a look at the prints here. So here's the sear laser lot. There was some drooping issues I had with this filament and cooling issues because the part cooling was turned off. Got some issues. I don't know if I had some extrusion issues at this location. Maybe it was getting a little bit clogged in the nozzle, but there's like a throughout the print some issue. So I don't know if that was just the printer. You can see it here, the issue I had, like here on the back side it printed fine. But because of cooling, the overhangs here were a little bit difficult. And the top side as well, a little bit rough because there was no part cooling fan. And I printed the oddest model by Gareth, and for most parts it came out pretty nice, but here on the top part where you really need to slow down the print or add cooling, a little bit of melting. As you can see, it came out pretty nice up to this point, but at this point it needed more cooling. So either add cooling or slow down the print for fine details like here on the top. But like the back side here came out really smooth and it's quite shiny and it's quite flexible material. It has pretty nice layer adhesion. It's really tough filament, but you just need to get the correct settings. I printed my Mr. Belly, and on this one I slowed down the print to see if I would get good results, like here in the head part, and this came out really nice. So the main thing to get good results with this filament is to print slowly, because you need the time for the filament to cool down. So this was looking pretty good, quite strong. It's quite difficult to to tear apart. Flexes, and it's tough material. But I always try to break the legs, and as you can see, it just bends. I can twist it, and so layer adhesion is quite strong. That will be it for this type of filament. It was a nice filament to try out. I just want to get more of it to try out to fine tune the settings to see what I can do. But that's the thing with the Makerbox samples, you get like a small sample to try out, and if you get into difficulties, it's difficult to finalize the best settings. But slowing down the print was the key for this filament, and the Mr. Belly came out pretty nice in the end. But this will be it for this filament. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.